Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. So today we are going to discuss about what is the need of the motor drives used in electric vehicle as well as hybrid electric vehicle, and next one we are going to discuss about what are the requirements of an propulsion motor. Okay, so when you are using the motors for electric vehicle application as well as hybrid electric vehicle application, what are the requirements of an electric motor? Okay, the first requirement is this motor should be capable of frequent start as well as start. Okay, so we should be able to frequently start the motor and frequently should stop the motor. That's the first requirement of an propulsion motor to be used in an electric vehicle. And this motor should have an higher rates of acceleration and higher rates of deacceleration. Okay, so what is the concept here is the motor what we are going to use should travel an ghat road which is having positive slope, and after climbing the ghat road it has to come down which offers a negative slope. So here the motor what we are using should have an the characteristics of under low speed it should offer high torque. Okay, under high speeds it should offer low torque. So these are the main requirements of an speed power torque characteristics of a motor to be used in electric vehicle or hybrid electric vehicle applications. And we had already told now the electric vehicle is propelling in an highway which has a positive slope and which was acting like a motor when it is trying to accelerate in negative slope will try to act like an generator. Okay, so therefore this is going to deaccelerate. So our electric vehicle motor should have an higher speeds of acceleration and higher speeds of deacceleration. So that's nothing but it should have the higher rates. So coming to the next requirement of an electric motor drive is it should be able to offer under low speeds it should deliver higher torque, and second one is under higher speeds it should offer lower torque. Already in the previous sessions we have been understand what are the speed power torque characteristics of our electric vehicle. So if you recall it, you can understand here roughly I am drawing the speed power torque. So on the x axis we are having speed and we are going to have three quadrants. One is nothing but here you are going to have constant torque and here you are going to have constant power. Okay, so initially this is the critical speed. So initially what happens is the torque is constant. I am taking the vehicle is running with constant torque. So the relation we have for the power and torque is equal to power is equal to torque into angular velocity. Angular velocity can be written as 2 pi n divided by 60. So here I am taking torque as a constant, therefore power is directly proportional to speed. Here power is directly proportional to speed. And next one I am assuming power as constant. So in the whenever the vehicle reaches the critical speed, here the power is constant. Whenever the power is constant, automatically we are going to get P divided by 2 pi n divided by 60, that is equal to torque. And you can see the relation here, torque as well as speed have an inverse relation. Okay, so this inverse relation I'm going to draw with the help of another color where you can understand better. So you can see here this has an inverse relation. You can see that at this point what's happening here is here speed is lower but torque is maximum. Okay, but at this point speed is greater, torque is lower, then I can say that this motor is exhibiting the hyperbolic characteristics. This is what the requirement. That's why in this region we are calling it as constant power characteristics, and this is the minimum speed of the motor, this is the rated speed which is called critical speed, and this is a higher speed. So when you join these two lines, then the resultant curve we are going to get like this. Okay, so this is our resultant curve where this curve is called as speed power torque characteristics of an electric vehicle. So our electric vehicle should have this. Okay, so that is the requirements of our electric vehicle. And the next requirement of our electric vehicle is the fourth requirement of the electric vehicle motor is it should have low speeds, hill climbing properties. Okay, so with low speed it should climb the ghat road and it should have an hill climbing properties. So this can be exhibited by this region. Okay, so under low speed, high torque has to be supplied. And next one is, so our electric vehicle should have the properties of wide speed range of operation. Okay, so it should have an wider speed range. Okay, it should be able to operate with 100 rpm varying to 3000 rpm, where we are having an wide speed range of operation is the next property required by an electric vehicle motor. So these are the basic requirements of an electric vehicle: frequent stop and stop, higher rates of acceleration as well as deacceleration, and this should have this speed power characteristics to be fulfilled. And these are the characteristics required by an drivetrain. This should be also be there. And already discussed, under low speed it should offer higher torque, under high speed it should offer low torque. Then definitely it has to satisfy the speed power torque characteristics of an electric vehicle. And this motor should have an wider range of speed operation. Okay, so this what the are the requirements of an electric vehicle. Now let's try to discuss about what is meant by a commutator, what is the need of brushes, and how to remove this commutator and brush, and what are the advantages we are going to get. Now let's try to see about this DC motor. So when you take this DC motor, so you have two types of parts. So this is nothing but the stator, and this is nothing but the rotor. So stator, what you are going to have, so on the rotor you are going to have the winding, where this winding is called armature winding, and the stator you are going to have the field winding. So DC motor is also an double fed. Okay, so here you can see here, so this ash colored is nothing but we are using an field winding. So you can use an electromagnet, or directly you can use an permanent magnet here also. Okay, so this is nothing but made up of a permanent magnet, or it may be made up of a electromagnet. And the center part, where the center part we are going to call it as a rotor, this winding is nothing but armature winding. And if it like a generator, or to supply to the rotor, we require the assembly of, so this is the shaft. On the shaft you have some commutator which converts AC to DC or DC to AC. Okay, so that is the main importance of this system. Okay, and next one, you can see here, this commutator is rotating, and the commutator is assembled to have an contact with the help of carbon brushes. So through carbon brushes we can supply the voltage to the rotor with the help of slip ring as well as the commutator. So this is what the importance of the parts of an DC motor. Now the problem is, so if you want to act this like an motor, we want to give the supply to the brushes. Through brushes it has to go to the commutator, then the voltage will be applied to the armature, and already this is an electromagnet, the motor principle will be satisfied and the motor starts propelling. But the problem here is, so there is a lot of loss, and we have to regularly replace this brushes, and we have to regularly replace this commutators. Why? Because it undergoes arcing, and they'll automatically arc will produce carbonization. So these brushes undergoes wear and tear. Okay, they reduce in their magnitude, so we need to replace. Indirectly you can see here how the assembly is there. So this is nothing but our armature, and these are nothing but different slots we have, and this is nothing but the commutator. Okay, and the commutator is assembled to the carbon brushes through a spring control, therefore they have a tension on this commutator. That's how it is having. Okay, so this is an overall view. So now the main need or the importance of an commutator is, so the purpose of an commutator as well as the brush, what they are actually doing in an DC motor. Okay, so they are used to feed the current into the armature. Okay, so to feed the current into the armature winding, we have to feed the current using brushes and commutator. So the purpose of brushes and commutators to feed the current into the armature winding. So in order to do this, we require the help of a commutator as well as brushes. When you use this kind of assembly, the problem we have is less reliable. The life of these carbon brushes is very, very less. They undergo wear and tear, and the life also get reduced, which is called reliability. So the life of these carbon brushes is less, therefore the overall life of the DC motor is less. And this is not so due to this carbon brushes and commutator assemble. This is unsuitable for maintenance free operation. So when you use this, you require a regular maintenance. So regular maintenance is in terms of changing carbon brushes. So we have to regularly change the carbon brushes, which is a lot of maintenance. So now we need to do some sort of modification, and we want to replace the commutator as well as the brushes, which is called commutatorless. Okay, so now therefore we can have some number of advantages in our motors. We want to make it like a new technological developments has to be developed to design an commutatorless machines or less motors. What is this commutatorless? Okay, so here when you use without commutation, what you have to do or how you have to remodify is, so when you are not having a commutator, these motors are going to offer us a higher efficiency. They offer higher efficiency when you don't have the commutator. Next one, they can have high power density. So these motors can offer high power density. So power density, units of power is watt, density is meter cube. For a given area of the motor, they can deliver highest power. It's called power density. And due to lack of, I mean, there's no maintenance. Why? Because there is no brushes. So commutator, and this is like we can call it as there's no brushless. Okay, there's no need of brushes and commutator. What happens is the operating, I mean, it is going to have low operating cost. So the operating cost of maintaining carbon brushes decreases. And next one, since there is no maintenance, high end efficiency is there, power density, they are having more life, where we are going to call this as these commutator or brushless are going to offer us more reliability. Is indirectly they offer more life. The life period of this motor is enhanced. And these motors are like maintenance-less, so there's no need to change the carbon brushes. So we can claim that this commutator-less or brushless are maintenance-less than compared to normal. Now let's try to compare the different types of motors. What are those commutator motors and what are commutator-less motors? Already we are clear here. So what is about an DC motor and its way of operating? Okay, so if you come to the DC motor, you are going to have these main parts. So you have an stator part and you have an rotor part. So this stator part already discussed, it consists of a field winding, where this winding is called field winding. So some motors may be directly an electromagnet, and here you have pole shoe or pole faces, and on the stator, what kind of winding you are going to have? Field winding. So this is all about the stator of an DC motor. And you are going to have the rotor. So this rotor is made up of a winding, where this winding is called as a armature winding, and this is called as a armature core. On this armature core, you are having armature winding. And how to supply the power to this DC motor is through the carbon brushes. Through carbon brushes, it goes to the commutator. Okay, so you have the shaft here. Through carbon brushes, we can supply the power to the rotor. So through brushes, it goes and reaches the commutator. And through commutator is connected to the armature coil. So these are called bearings, and this is nothing but the shaft. So this is the basic components of an electric vehicle. Sorry, electric vehicle is nothing but especially DC motor. Okay, so now you are clear about the parts of an DC motor. Now let's try to segregate our motor drives as commutator motors and commutator less motors. Okay, so in upcoming video we can have this classification. This is an overall view about so what are the requirements of a motor and what are the speed and torque characteristics, what are the parts of an DC motor, and how to convert these brushes and the brushless motor, and what are the advantages we are going to get. So if you feel the content is useful, please give a like and share the content with your friends, and give your valuable comments in comment section, which will your doubts will be clarified. So thank you for watching. We'll meet in next video about the classifications of DC motor drives.